All right, in this episode, I'm going to take apart a Kast King Kodiak model 5000. It's in this neoprene case right now because I've already got it spooled up and put on one of my Browning fishing rods. Comes with this neoprene case, and as you can see, you can put it on with the rod. You just have to take the handle off. Once you put the handle back on, you're good to go and ready to go fishing. So we're going to take this thing apart. I'm going to show you what the gears look like inside. I always like to do that on any new fishing reel that I obtain, just to see what the quality is like. I have a feeling these things are going to be pretty good because Kast King is not one of these here today, gone tomorrow import companies that's just sticking their name on any old thing. They really screen their product very well and test them before they release it to the public. So this one is no exception. It's a beauty. Look at this thing. It's got brown anodizing, gold anodizing, super smooth. It will spin forever. And it's very well balanced. Even the little fighting knob, it's like a, if you're not catching fish, you can use it as a fidget spinner. It'll spin forever. It's got 10 plus one ball bearings, the plus one being the anti-reverse. So let's open this thing up and see what it's made like. All right, so it's got, looks like torque head screws through most of it until you take this plastic cover off. Then you have a Phillips slash straight combination screw. But everything else is like a, I believe it's a T4 or smaller T3 maybe, Torx. It's very well put together. It's very tight tolerance. The most of the parts are metal on this. The only plastic parts I found, like I say, with the bumper on the back side of it and a couple little side trim pieces on the rotor. The rotor is super lightweight and very well balanced. Has a very large diameter bale, and even the at the end of the bale, there's a ball bearing roller on the line guide. So they're putting bearings underneath of the like dual bearings stacked on top of each other underneath of the spool, so it stays good and balanced and tight, doesn't wiggle. Also makes for a smoother drag. It's not going to take as much to activate the drag as some of the older style reels. So a lot of these new modern reels coming out today are much better than what we had back when I was growing up as a kid. I mean, this is under $100, so it's in the right target price range. And this is the largest of the Kodiak series by Kast King. They make smaller than this. This size is fairly decent, though. I mean, it's not too big. It's lightweight enough to cast it without, you know, wearing yourself out. But as you see here now that we got it open, the pinion gear is a CNC machined brass pinion gear, and that's mating up to a aluminum die cast or aluminum alloy of some sort die cast style crown gear. And it's got a, looks like a stainless steel gear pressed inside of that to use for the oscillating up and down motion, or the line lay motion. They call it oscillation gear. And it looks like everything else has got some die-cast parts inside also. But that's typical for a reel of this nature. And looks like it's got bearings, shielded stainless steel ball bearings throughout. This, like I say, the main shaft is oversized too. It's 4 millimeter diameter. And looks like there's a lot of all-metal parts, even on the little clicker that makes the drag audible. It's all got metal springs and metal gears there to make the audible sounds even, which on some higher end reels that I paid a lot more money for than this, had plastic parts, which I wasn't too happy with. But everything looks to be well made and a good choice of material. The drag looks like it's got a nice number of drag washers, the carbon fiber type that doesn't matter if they get wet. Have a metal one. Then we have another set of carbon fiber drag washers. Then we've got another set of carbon fiber and stainless drag washers. impressed with the machine quality of this. Very, very adequate. There must be several ball bearings. This thing is silky smooth, this fighting knob. So let's see. They're showing two ball bearings just in the fighting knob. There's your drag washers. Ball bearing on your line roller up here on your bale. So very impressed with the quality and the color and the shape and everything of this reel. It's got a slight angle, as you can see, points up to the guidelines. I put it on a Browning, an old Browning rod, because it's kind of the exact color of the reel. So for now, I'm just going to put it on that and use it in fresh water, because I don't have time this year to get to the ocean and do any saltwater fishing. But this thing is saltwater approved. Very, very strong and heavy duty drag. It's got like a 39 pound drag is what I heard somewhere. I'm quite impressed with this, and like I say, it comes from a reputable company. It's not one of these here today, gone tomorrow name brands. Kast King's been around for a while and it's growing in popularity. So you can check them out at kastking.com. This is going to be one of my main fishing reels for this summer. So anyway, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.